Here's how I replaced these broken countertops for less than $1,000 and made it look like this. If you're new here, I'm Lena. I show you how to transform outdated spaces and furniture and make them flipping gorgeous. In today's video, I'm showing you how I replaced old broken granite countertops with beautiful butcher block from Hardwood Reflections. So in the show notes below, I've actually have a free download where you can get my entire shopping list for everything that I used in this kitchen, along with some helpful links on how to install the butcher block yourselves. Consider subscribing if you want to follow along with all of my DIYs and learn helpful and easy ways to transform spaces. So thanks for being here. Let's get into the video. All right, guys, I'm ready to tackle my next big project. We have been slowly making over our house, especially the kitchen, since we bought it about 2 years ago. And the thing that I've been wanting to do is change these old black granite countertops that are broken in several places. But instead of just breaking them up, I'm going to try to salvage them. Step one, box cutter. And you're gonna cut these seams right here, just so that we can kind of loosen up the countertop.
Most countertops are actually just held on by silicone glue. So by scoring the edges, it makes it easier to take them off.
I'm gonna put a shim in between the cabinet and the base so that we can easily lift it up.
Once I had them loose enough, it was time to bring in the muscle, AKA my husband. And again, the goal was try to remove these in as large as pieces as possible so that I could sell them on Facebook Marketplace and they could be repurposed. It was my goal to salvage and waste as little as possible. Once we had the granite countertops out, there was still an amount of silicone against the backsplash, so I wanted to pull this all out and make it very clean so that the new hardwood countertops could go in easily. I'm pretty sure there was still construction debris from when this house was built 20 years ago when I took off all the countertops. Once I got all the countertops off, I noticed they were uneven, so I decided to build a plywood base just so the new countertops would have a nice level surface. Here's a cool tip. Home Depot will actually cut plywood and other things down to size for you. So I got the plywood cut down to what I needed, and then I found the butcher block. I went with the birch hardwood reflections. They keep it in stock at Home Depot, and then I got back and I started building the plywood base. Then it was time to really determine how I was going to install and conjoin the butcher block pieces. This is where the YouTube videos from Hardwood Reflections were super helpful, and I've linked them below. I either had the option to miter the corner so that it would be kind of like triangular or butt the two ends together, and I really wanted to make the most of the countertop cut, so I decided to butt the ends rather than miter them. You can see here I played everything out, measured it, and then it was time to make my cuts. Before making the cuts, I sealed the underneath portion of the butcher block with a sealant. This will help it from warping in the future. Again, all of the products that I use are listed in that free download in the show notes. When it came time to cut the butcher block, I used a straight edge tool that clamped on. I also used wood clamps to keep it in place. And don't be a dum-dum like me. Make sure you're wearing eye protection in this video. I did, but this particular one, I don't have it on. And then I cut all the pieces off just using my circular saw. It was actually quite easy. I just took my time and went very slow. And again, using that masking tape to help prevent the edges from chipping. The most intimidating part of cutting the butcher block was for the sink. The sink that I purchased came with a template, so we just put it on. I decided I was gonna do an overmount sink to help prevent water from getting on the butcher block edges, and I just cut it out using the template. It was actually quite easy. Once everything was cut, I sanded down the very top of the butcher block just to make it super smooth before I stained it. And I decided that I wanted to stain the butcher block because we had these beautiful dark floors and I thought they would look really good if they match, because what goes above goes below is a general design concept. So you can see here I had everything put together. I stained the pieces after they were cut, but before they were installed. And I used this Kona gel stain. And honestly, you can go very light on the stain. The butcher block really absorbs it. And just wipe it on and then wipe it off. My brother was here helping me. He was such a doll. And I just, again, thought this color was so rich and so beautiful and matched the floors. It also gave the kitchen a lot of warmth because we had these white cabinets and white marble backsplash and the big quartz island. Once I had the butcher block installed, I then sealed it so that it could cure and be food safe if I wanted to prep on top of the staining. But I actually never had any intention of really prepping because we had this large quartz island in the center, which is where I would prep food for. To seal the butcher block countertops, I use a Watco butcher block sealant, and you can also use Waterlux or any tongue oil, but I just love how this turned out. It brought so much warmth to the kitchen.
I'd love for you to tell me in the comments below the most interesting part of the video for you.